Greetings, humans. In this video, we will be examining for the first time in history the original equipment used to create the voice of the Cylon from the 1978 series Battlestar Galactica. Let us begin by your command.
Hey guys, my name is Joe Grandberg. I'm here at Boogie Dungeon Studios in Auburn, California. And like many of you Battlestar Galactica fans and synthesizer lovers, I've wondered my whole life, how did they make the voice of the Cylon? There's been a lot of speculation about the gear used, the vocoder, the synthesizer, the studio processing. So today, thanks to a lucky connection that I made this past year, I contacted possibly the last person alive who was in the studio and recorded the voice of the Cylon, hands-on, worked with the gear, ran the process, as he said, front in the trenches for Universal Studios, and I was fortunate enough to get him on the phone for about 20-25 minutes, and he just laid it all on me, and I feel like a weight's been taken off my shoulders and the mystery's been solved. The agony is over, and today we're going to share that with you so the agony can be over for you too and examine some of this wonderful gear. We're going to dive right into step one, the synthesizer tone.
According to my source, the synthesizer used to create the tone that is the basis of the Cylon voice was an ARP 2500. It was manufactured from 1970 until 1981, with only 100 units being produced, and it's estimated that there's about 50 units left in the world fully functional. One of the main tone generators or oscillators of the ARP 2500 was and is very unique. The ARP 2500 oscillator allows you to mix and combine up to 5 different waveforms in their positive and negative shape, as well as pulse width modulation. This allows the user to create an almost unlimited variety of sounds, which in my opinion is why the Cylon voice has never really been duplicated, because the chance of somebody owning this unique synthesizer as well as an EMS 1000, 2000, or 3000 vocoder and knowing what to look for is very small. Based upon my experimentation with the real ARP 2500 that I visited for a day, as well as working with this virtual software clone, in my opinion, the tone used to generate the Cylon voice is a combination of 2 or 3 different oscillators. On a side note, the synthesizer used to make the Cylon voice belonged to legendary film composer Jerry Goldsmith, and for whatever reason, the synth was present at Universal Studios at that time. I assume he was working on a soundtrack, but by 1980, for the series Galactica 1980, the oscillators had been backed up to a tape reel for consistency. Now, it's possible that Jerry Goldsmith just needed to take his synthesizer home with him, but it's very important to point out that on the early analog modular synthesizers, the oscillator pitch was often unstable due to the nature of the electronic circuit and being affected by temperature and other reasons. And this is what created some of that detuned, strange, trashy sound of the Cylon voice.
One ship destroyed. One probable contact patrol leader. Garrison command to patrol leader.
When you have 2 or 3 tones of different shapes playing together, being mixed together, and one of them is slightly out of tune, that totally changes the harmonic structure of the tone. And that's why some of these sounds in the Cylon voice have this weird, can't put your finger on it, trashy, detuned sound, as I call it, that I have never been able to figure out. However, even when the oscillators were perfectly in tune with each other, there is something weird about the main fundamental pulse width modulated tone that they chose as the basis of the Cylon voice. It has a harmonic stair step structure offering strange tritonal rings that are very unique and I believe were chosen to offer the maximum amount of intelligibility for the voice of the Cylon character.
Of the Galactica. They are heading toward the plateau.